Brasil e estima que é o mais.
I gotta go to church to find out for sure.
Our first guest is a three-time Academy Award winner, ladies and gentlemen, the most nominated actor in history. She is starring in a new film entitled Into the Woods. It opens Christmas Day. Perfect Christmas offering. Please welcome the lovely, talented Meryl Streep. Coming to the program. How you doing? How's the family? Everybody good?
Everybody's currently good. Yeah.
I think four kids. Am I right about that?
Yes, I do.
Now, am I right when I say each one involved in some aspect of the performing arts?
You would be wrong.
I would be wrong?
Yes.
Okay, take us through this if you can.
Well, there's only one that isn't.
Okay. What does that one do?
Well, she's the best one.
Really?
I'm just kidding.
Chronologically, where does she fit in the four?
She's the youngest.
The youngest, so there's still hope.
She's working at an advertising agency. Uh-huh. She has an actual job. She goes every day.
Yeah.
Never misses. You know.
Good for her.
Yeah.
And the others, I know you have a musician.
Musician is my son. He's the oldest. And Mamie and Grace are both actresses.
They're both actresses. Now, this is good, right? To have actors and stuff in the family?
Yeah. I mean, I'm very proud of them. Basically, I think it's probably pretty daunting to be my child and say, you know, this is what you're going to do. And I think they're very brave or, you know, nuts.
I think it's a great legacy. I think it's a great thing. But you have cast a pretty long shadow.
Yeah, but they're good. You know, they're really good.
Do you go see everything they're in?
No, I don't. I'm not allowed to see certain things.
Oh, because the...
It would upset me. I heard about a scene Grace was in that she said, you are never to watch this, so... In American Horror, whatever.
Would this suggest nudity?
No, it's cruelty.
Ooh.
Yeah.
That's even worse, isn't it?
Worse than nudity, yeah. really.
And do you ever swing by the ad agency and spend the day there?
Oh, she would really love that.
Oh, my God.
She's delightful. Yeah.
Meryl Streep is an open cubicle six.
Oh, God.
Well, you look wonderful. You look festive and holiday-like.
Nice to
see you. There, no secret, there's a lot of late-night television shows, and if you're clicking around the dial and you're looking at this one and looking at that one or checking out the Jimmys, if you don't have Meryl Streep on your show tonight, you really don't have. Nothing to do with me. We had Emily Blunt was on the program, and she told a story, and I don't know if you can tell these stories offset. I don't know if there's a confidentiality about there or a code of behavior, but she said that you were on a table, and you were going to do something, and you get caught in your dress, and you nearly landed on your face. And she said that, and by the way, she was several months pregnant at the time, and threw herself between you and the steel floor and saved your life.
Well, I hate to contradict her, but she did try to save me. But I think that I her foot.
Oh. Well.
Which she had thrown up onto the table in an attempt to kill me.
Yeah.
And then realizing that it was the first day of rehearsal, and they didn't know who they'd be cast.
What has been a staple of our time on television, following myself, whenever we get actors, actresses, young, or maybe not so young, first time to have worked with you, it's always, what was that like working with Meryl Streep? You must have been scared silly. And you know, they always are.
No.
You must love that.
Yeah, it's kind of like you. I mean, people are scared of you.
Oh, are they really?
Yes, they are. It's kind of fun, isn't it? Yeah.
A little bit.
No, I know that. That's on like this big train that's coming in, you know, with a lot of steam and noise and funk, you know. And, that's the word I
Yes,
love.
It is.
Yeah, I love
Absolutely.
It.
Absolutely. I've been
Grand Funk Railroad. Funk. I think I was thinking
Grand
of it.
Grand Funk Railroad. There you go.
But, I think it's a little overblown, you know, the expectation.
I love it. I mean, I always love asking the question. And, you know, they've all got a story prepared about how, well, they saved your life or something.
Yeah,
it's
right.
They're all ready to go. I was so impressed, I guess it was maybe a month ago, you and others received the Presidential Medal of Freedom. Now, this is a big deal, isn't it? And notified, I think, I would guess, at the very highest level. You got a call from whom?
Yeah, well, we were shooting a film in the fall. A rock and roll movie that had to come to a screeching halt because this call was coming in from Air Force One and they wanted to talk to me, and I was really scared that I'd done something wrong.
Yeah, I saw you doing something.
Anyway, it was Valerie Jarrett, who's the advisor to the president, and she told me about this. And I was, you know, flabbergasted and also chagrined because I tried to talk them out of it. Yeah, because I didn't deserve it. You know, I felt that it's such a high honor. And, but then they told me that all sorts of wonderful artists get it and golfers and ball players, and I felt better.
Yeah, they're giving it to golfers. But it represents the highest civilian honor this the country may bestow upon a citizen.
And it is. It's just, you know, supposedly for the contribution of your lifetime. And then it makes me really feel old and think, well, what have I done? And I am trying to live up to, you know, the honor and stay on the straight and narrow from here on.
Yeah, that's out. Right. Now you really got to be paid. The thing about it is you've never been more productive in your craft, you know, which is a great thing for actors and actors. Age really is not a factor. In fact, it can be useful to an actor or an actress, can't it?
Yeah, you get great parts as witches.
Yeah. I want to show this is the ceremony in the White House. This is you receiving the award. And boy, it's a beautiful medal, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
It's fantastic. And they say a few words and then they put that on?
Yeah. The president says a few words. Yeah. He said he loved me. And a few other things.
Well, congratulations.
That was really great.
sure which one. I was reading about Mamma Mia.
Yeah.
And I don't know if you've seen the books on this film or not.
Mm-hmm.
$600 million.
Yeah, I think it's closer to $800
million. Oh, sorry. $800 million. $800 million. A musical, and who knew that a musical could be so lucrative? And now you're back in another musical, mm-hmm. and you must be terribly excited about it.
Yeah, I am. I mean, this is a great, great musical.
Right.
Music by Stephen Sondheim and directed by Rob Marshall, who sort of is responsible for some of the revival of interest in musicals, mm-hmm. with Chicago winning Best Picture.
Right.
He did that one.
Did you get a piece of this $800 million?
One would hope, yes. I've been living off of it, really.
Well, as we like to say, it's nice to see things finally beginning to go your way.
Yeah, no.
And where did they shoot this? I think that they shot it in Central Park. I know that's not true. Where did they shoot the movie?
They shot it in a studio in England,
yeah.
in Shepperton Studios, and a great big hangar, like an airline hangar. Mm-hmm. I think the biggest studio in England.
Yeah.
And they built trees that I thought were like too big, you know. I thought they went over the top.
Mm-hmm.
And then we went out to shoot into the forest in England, and there's a forest called in Windsor that has some of the oldest trees in Europe there, 500 years old, and they're that big.
They really are that big.
They're as big as this room, practically.
Wow.
They're really beautiful, beautiful trees. And I was acting in a lot of them, jumping up and climbing. So it was
In a situation like that, you're in the forest in England, and it's raining, it's damp, and and you're tired, and you're chilled. And do you ever just go bitch crazy on them? Have you ever just, I don't want to be here.
No, but Emily Blunt did.
I knew it. I knew she pulled something like that. Let's look at a clip here, Into the Woods. This is going to be enormous. This is the perfect Christmas Day motion picture. After you've had your wings, sure. What is the clip here we're going to see?
I think you're going to see, I'm not sure. It might be one where I feel terrified.
You don't need to.
I don't. Okay, thank you.
That's for others to worry.
Yes, I have staff.
Yeah, take a look at the clip. See what happens here.
Princes wait there in the world, it's true. Princes, yes, but wolves and humans too. Stay at home, I am wolf. Who are they?
Good to see you. Great supporting. Thank you so much. We'll be right back to Global Wilson. Club Open Christmas Day. Harold Street, everybody.
I say it while you're leaving the cake.